It is indeed my pleasure to be here with my brothers and sisters. And I'm going to say that again to my brothers and sisters of the AFL-CIO and anyone else that represents the unions. What is a union? Why do we have a union? Who are they? Geez, unions are plumbers, carpenters, electricians, masons, teachers, firemen, policemen. I think that's the American people, isn't it? That's the American people. Why do we have a union? Because before we had a union, workers were mistreated. I come from coal country, Northeast Pennsylvania. My dad was a miner. My uncles were miners. I understand the conditions that they had to work in. But those conditions were far better than it was before they had a union. You know, people died trying to fight for fairness. All unions try to do is get the best they can for the workers, the American worker. Is there anything wrong with that? I don't think so. It's in collective bargaining. It's under the auspices of a legal procedure. They have a right, the employer has a right to say no, say yes, come to middle ground. That's what life is all about, bargaining. That's what the American people want now with government. Come on, guys, make some improvements. Move the bar forward. Why do we have this log jam? Nothing's getting done. I want to make a very important point here today. There are terrific, dedicated, qualified legislators on both sides of the aisle that are fighting every day for fairness and justice. But unfortunately, on the other side of the aisle, there's been a group of extremists that have taken over, and they are changing what we have all fought for literally decades. Why do I say that? Well, over the last session, I just started to collect some of the pieces of legislation that has been submitted for our votes, for consideration. Today, we're talking about right to work. Page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4, all anti-union bills, all anti-worker bills. What are they? Paycheck protection. Those of you that know about that, again, another slick terminology to masquerade what this is all about, to eliminate the opportunity for people to have their union dues taken out of their pay, like what banks demand for all of us. Right to work, right to work for less. The statistics are here. You make less in those states. Well, if the worker makes less, who makes more? Guy on the top, the big guys. I'm not against them. I applaud them for the success. We're asking for fairness. Fairness. Don't take away the living wage. Eliminate collective bargaining. Why do you want to do that? Don't you want to have a productive discussion with your employees? Know what they need, know what they want. How can we improve the business? You should be working together as a team. Don't divide that team. You eliminate your productivity. Prevailing wage, another misunderstood title that they're going after, to eliminate prevailing wage. How about this one? Let's eliminate the Apprentice and Training Council. Why do you want to eliminate the Apprentice and Training Council? Don't we all understand the unions have the finest education system to train every one of their apprentices? So when they graduate from their system after 5 years, they are certified, they do their job, they are qualified. By the way, the unions do their job, they get it done on time. because of this education system. And by the way, it doesn't cost the taxpayer 1 cent. They fund it themselves. Who are the unions? The American people, for God's sake. Don't divide us. There's enough of this division on a state level. We are all Americans first. I'm going to come back one more time and make this statement. There are dedicated, qualified, concerned legislators on both sides of the aisle. Just because these are all Republican bills doesn't mean that all Republicans think this way. But there's that group that's driving these divisions in our society.